So we're talking about multi-reaction equilibria. If there is a reaction going on, A plus B gives you C, and A reacts also with D to form E and C, we can see that there are two species, A and C, which are taking part in both the reaction. So when you want to do that, what we need to do is we need to extend our mathematics, which was there for a single reaction, to multi, reaction. So change in number of moles of any species, say for example A, is equal to change in number of extent of reaction for individual reaction, like epsilon 1 for this and epsilon 1 2 for this, multiplied by stoichiometric coefficient of a species in jth reaction. So like for A, in first reaction it is 1, so it is 1 into epsilon 1, plus in second reaction it is 2 into epsilon. But suppose B, which is present only in 1, for that the stoichiometric coefficient for reaction 2 would be 0, so there it will be only 1 into epsilon 1. For D, it will be 1 into epsilon 2. For C, it will be 1 into epsilon 1 plus 1 into epsilon 2. And for E, it will be only epsilon 2. So likewise, we can extend it to multi-reaction. And the same thing which we did, we can integrate, and we can eventually come to this as a mathematics. However, it is very easy to implement when we talk about a reaction. Like if we have a methane with steam giving carbon monoxide and hydrogen, methane with 2 moles of steam giving you carbon dioxide and 4 moles of hydrogen, and if the initial number of moles CH4 are 2 and H2O is 3, we can write YIs as, say for example for methane it is 3 minus epsilon 1 minus epsilon 2. For H2O it is for methane it is 2 minus epsilon 1 minus epsilon 2. For H2O it is 3 minus epsilon 1 minus 2 epsilon 2. For CO it is epsilon 1. For hydrogen it is 3 epsilon 1 plus 4 epsilon 2, and for CO2 it is epsilon 2, and these are all final number of moles at equilibrium. You make summation of that will give you final number of total moles, and just divide individual number of moles with final number of moles, that will give you the mole fraction. So this can be converted into a tabular form like this, and this is overall stoichiometric coefficient, and this is what you can get. So The easiest way to do this is find out individual number of moles by just looking at the reaction and stoichiometry. Like for methane, again I am repeating, 2 minus epsilon 1 minus epsilon 2. For H2O it is 3 minus epsilon 1 minus 2 epsilon 2. For CO it is epsilon 1. For hydrogen it is 3 epsilon 1 plus 4 epsilon 2, because this being product, and CO2 it is epsilon 2. So now these are all number of moles at equilibrium. Make the summation of that. That gives you denominator term, which is equal to 5 plus 2 epsilon 1 plus 2 epsilon 2. And these are all individual number of moles. So that's how you can find out the mole fractions. So this is how you can find out the number of moles and mole fraction for different species taking part in reaction where the more than one reaction takes place. Now, very important thing about extent of reaction is, general concept is that extent of reaction can't go beyond 1. As such, extent of reaction is number of moles, and it can go even beyond 1. It all depends on the stoichiometry and initial number of moles. Like in this case, your initial number of moles of methane is 2 and H2O is 1. So in that case, the limiting factor is number of moles of H2O, and you can't go beyond 1 for epsilon, reason being after 1, the final number of moles of H2 is 1 minus epsilon, so that value cannot go below 0, right? But say for example, if the stoichiometry is like this, only single reaction taking place, 2A plus D gives you E plus C. And in this case, suppose if 1 mole of A is reacting with, 1 mole of D, in this case, your epsilon can go maximum 0.5, reason being stoichiometric requires for 1 mole of D to react 2 moles, whereas we start with 1 mole. In the same way, suppose if I start with 10 initial moles of A and 10 initial number of moles of D, my maximum possible value of epsilon is 5. But suppose if I have 10 moles of A and 20 moles of A and 10 moles of D, I will be able to have 10 as epsilon. So epsilon can be any value, reason being it is a unit of number of moles. There is no limitation of on epsilon, provided it satisfies the stoichiometry and the availability of the initial number of moles. So but then this epsilon will be able to help you out in finding out conversion, which is always less than 100%. How do we define conversion? Is the number of moles reacted divided by fair. So epsilon will always tell you what is the number of moles which have reacted. So this is how you can find out mole fraction of any given single or multi reaction, and this can be then related with some other properties to find out extent of reaction, which we'll see in coming videos. Thank you.